COVID milestone for Australia today, and it's not a good one. Mandatory RAT reporting and big fines being introduced, and the Novak visa saga drags on. It's Wednesday, January 12. Hi, it's Amy Drew with your news briefing. More than 100,000 new COVID cases have been recorded across Australia today, along with 49 deaths. Victoria has the highest tally in the country, with just over 40,000 new infections and 21 deaths. New South Wales and South Australia will be the first states to introduce mandatory reporting for positive rapid antigen tests from next week. It's a pretty big deal, especially for New South Wales, with today's figures including 35,000 positive RATs. And despite supply continuing to be a massive issue across the country, Premier Dominic Perrottet is confident the at-home testing will get us through 2022.
Clearly, supply is still a challenge across the country. We have put an order in 50 million and are procuring an additional 50 million. In the main, they will be used to support essential service delivery here in our state through our schools, transport, and health work.
Well, Queensland's Health Minister Yvette Darth has again called on the federal government to ramp up supply, saying it's taking a massive toll on business.
I know a lot of people are ordering them online at the moment. I know a lot of the sites online all say out of stock. I know people, the moment they come on the shelves in our supermarkets and our pharmacies, they're going again. Is there ready supply out there that anyone who wants one can get one? No.
Tennis star Novak Djokovic has broken his silence, releasing a statement about his ongoing visa dramas. He's addressed a speculation that he lied on his entry application about travelling outside of Serbia in the 2 weeks before arriving down under, saying he ticked the incorrect box in an act of human error. Novak also said he was unaware that he had tested positive for COVID when he attended a tennis event overseas in December. Immigration Minister Alex Hawke is likely to make a decision tomorrow about whether or not to cancel his visa for a second time. It comes as an investigation starts after a video was leaked of Channel 7 news presenters off-air trash-talking Novak Djokovic, using some pretty colourful language. And here's a new strain we can get on board with. Tearless onions will start rolling out in UK markets from next week after decades of crossbreeding dubbed sunions. Checking sport now, high praise for Usman Khawaja coming from the English camp in Hobart today. Aussie selectors grappling with a decision on whether to play him in the final test this Friday. English skipper Joe Root says he had a superb match in Sydney.
Personally, I think he's a wonderful player. And I think as well he's at a period of his career where he's very content with his game. He's got an understanding of how he wants to go and play. It was a phenomenal effort. What he managed to achieve last week was truly brilliant.
While Australia has unveiled its 15-player squad for the seven-game Women Ashes series, Scorchers star Alana King is in line to make her international debut, but selector Sean Flegler says Amanda Jade Wellington has missed out.
Alana got the nod this time, but what I've said to all the players, they need to be ready just in case something does happen, and we're confident that if COVID hit the squad and Amanda was called up into the senior team, then she could actually play a role. It would be a slightly different role.
And Adelaide are narrow favourites to win just their third Big Bash match of the season when they take on Brisbane Heat at the Gamma tonight.
The Snooze Super Summer Sale is now on. Save up to 50% on mattresses and up to 40% on bed frames. Exclusions, T's and C's apply.
Checking sport now, high praise for Usman Khawaja coming from the English camp in Hobart today. Aussie selectors grappling with a decision on whether to play him in the final test this Friday. English skipper Joe Root says he had a superb match in Sydney.
Personally, I think he's a wonderful player. And I think as well he's at a period of his career where he's very content with his game. He's got an understanding of how he wants to go and play. It's a phenomenal effort. What he managed to achieve last week was truly brilliant.
While Australia has unveiled its 15-player squad for the seven-game Women Ashes series, Scorchers star Alana King is in line to make her international debut, but selector Sean Flegler says Amanda Jade Wellington has missed out.
Alana got the nod this time, but what I've said to all the players, they need to be ready just in case something does happen, and we're confident that if COVID hit the squad and Amanda was called up into the senior team, then she could actually play a role. It would be a slightly different role.
And Adelaide are narrow favourites to win just their third Big Bash match of the season when they take on Brisbane Heat at the Gamma. Weather showers for the rest of today, getting down to 23 degrees tonight. Partly cloudy skies tomorrow with a chance of a shower and a top of 33. Our listener app is the new home of your local news. Join to listen live or on demand now.